We're joined now by England and Arsenal legend Rachel Yanke with the biggest smile on her face. It was a great moment, wasn't it?
Oh, it was fantastic. From the first second to the end, what a great game of football, and they were amazing. And previous games, the performances have been in and out, and they've played OK in spells, but that whole game, they were really good, every player, and, yeah, fingers crossed that he can go all the way.
Of course, we're not getting carried away with ourselves. You've been there, you've played for the England team, you've played in successful England teams. We want to get beyond the semi-final, but the next opponent, potentially the French or the Americans. Talk us through the merits of both those teams.
Well, they play tonight, so it'll be you know, one of the teams is going to get knocked out. It will be.
Who
a
are you
really
hoping
difficult...
goes tonight? Would you prefer us to face?
I think because of the way that we played yesterday in our aggressive style of football, I think we better favour USA.
Really?
The world champions. Because I watched USA play against Spain. Spain were really unlucky to lose the game and go out. Two penalty decisions knocked them out. But they were aggressive. They didn't let USA have much time on the ball. They really sort of stifled USA. And I think this England team could do the same thing and get the better of USA. And they fear nobody, this team. And I think that's the biggest thing, is that they've got confidence and they'll keep pushing on.
They've definitely developed each game as they've gone on, and they sort of seem like they've really found their stride. They look so fit yesterday compared to the Norwegians in what is blistering heat as well.
Yes.
Feels like they've been properly prepared and conditioned for this World Cup.
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, lots of people have talked about it and had questions, and I've sort of thought when Phil Neville kept changing the teams in the group stages, you know, playing so many players, every outfield player has had minutes on the pitch, but they've put themselves in a position that they can afford to rotate the team, and that's kept people fresh and later on in the stages of the tournament that shows, and the way that they played yesterday, they've just got energy, and that will build confidence, and fingers crossed, you know, whoever they play, whether it's France or USA, they'll do really well. It's gripped the nation from what the players are doing, and that's every country, what the players are doing on the pitch, but also Phil Neville gives it that little bit of profile, and also, the standard that he brings, he makes it. I've spoke to some of the players. There's no question about what they need to do, and he would have learned that from the best.
Is this the best squad we've ever had at this stage?
It's difficult to go back and look through previous teams, but they have got the fantastic opportunity and the best opportunity to go and win this.
Can't have you on without briefly mentioning you being a trailblazer and soccer aides.
Yeah.
We got to play together. Did you enjoy the experience?
Oh, I loved it. I was, I'm not going to lie, I was a little bit nervous before, because I haven't played in about 3 years. So, thinking...
That's such a relief for me to hear.
Or even someone like she.
Exactly, with all your experience, because you and Katie on our side just were superb.
Yeah. Katie's a fantastic footballer, and, you know, she's as fit as anything.
She is,
runs marathons and just keeps going. But, you know, what was brilliant is that the profile of it, we wanted to just go there and be seen as footballers. And the fact that everybody on the pitch was... We didn't get it treated any differently from anybody else. I mean, you asked Michael Essien.
He went straight through, didn't he?
He went through both of us. But do you know what? He saw us as footballers, and that's the biggest thing that I can take from it, is that we played football in a style of football that, you know, was how football should be played, and we were treated no differently.
Would you have fancied a penalty, though, Yanks? Would you quite like to step up and take one on the night?
After seeing what some of us did. No, I'm only joking. We were unlucky. We needed the VAR rule.
Yes, exactly. We looked at that, then when I came in, they were off the line. If that had been the Women's World Cup, every one would have been retaken.
I know.
Miles
let
off the line.
Can't let it go.
We've got next year. We'll be back, won't we, Yanks?
Of course.
Lovely to see you, Rachel. Thank you so much for coming in. Hopefully we'll be back and we'll be celebrating next Wednesday morning, and then potentially, fingers crossed, for the final as well. Great to see you.